Hey friends, it's Jeremy from Tested. It's my favorite time of year when I get to share with you my favorite things of 2019. I have four things for you today, starting with Turing Tumble. Now, this was a Kickstarter in 2018. I got it from my family for the last holiday. We opened it and I was quite blown away. I can't tell you how much I love this. It is successful on like three fronts. Check it out, okay? On the basic level, it's a kinetic ball machine, and you get to watch ball bearings tumble through these various parts in a very soothing, you know, way, and it just feels good to watch these chain reactions happen. That's just fun. On the second level, it's a puzzle game, right? So the game gives you these setups, and they give you all these various parts, and then they tell you, these are the parts you can use to complete the puzzle. And then you have to place them and learn and figure out where they're supposed to go in order to produce the desired output. You have these blue marbles and red marbles, and they will end up on the bottom here in various orders based on the pattern of parts that they flow through, okay? And all of those instructions are given to you in the form of this comic book story where you're a woman who crash lands on an alien planet and you stumble upon this alien architecture, and inside there's this technology that's broken and your life support is running out, and with your final breaths you repair their computer, and their computer is what you have on the game Turing Tumble itself. And then when you repair the first computer, the very first puzzle, the life support systems come to life in this alien structure, and then you are presented with another piece of technology that you have to figure out, and it's alien. And then once you learn how it works, it basically comes back to life and you proceed to the next puzzle. And what you end up doing is you come to this third part that Turing Tumble is so good at, and that's it teaches you, whether you know it or not, how computers count numbers. Because you're basically building very simple computers here. That's why it's called Turing Tumble. It's named for Alan Turing, one of the fathers of computers themselves. So this mechanism right here actually counts the number of marbles that fall through the contraption. And they do so with these blue parts right here, which are called bits. And when you have four bits, this is puzzle number 21. I know it seems very complicated, but you get to this point, you start to understand it. Four bits, they call a register. And using that register, you can actually count up to 15, 0 to 15, and you put however many marbles you up here, and this will actually reflect the number of marbles that pass through it. And by the end of the book, if you can get through the puzzles, you are making literal calculators that can multiply any number that you give it by any number you give it, and it actually figures it out. It's amazing. I mean, this is an aha factory, and I highly recommend it to anyone with kids, anyone who wants to take some time to learn this stuff. There's no batteries required, and it is successful on so many levels. Highly recommended. Now, from more subversive learning to the more overt learning, we have the Circuit Playground Express from Adafruit. Now, I get asked all the time on Twitter, Jeremy, how should I learn Arduino? I don't know a thing about programming. I don't know anything about electronics. Should I get an Arduino? What kit should I buy, right? Arduino itself, if you just buy an Arduino and you want to learn how to program, that's great, but all you can really do with that little box is make an LED flash, right? To do anything more, you have to hook up wires, maybe do some soldering, find the right components. It's a lot to ask somebody who's just putting their toe in the water. The Circuit Playground comes with all of that stuff already on there. You've got 10 RGB LEDs that can be any color. It detects touch, capacitive touch. It detects motion with an accelerometer, okay? It can detect temperature, it can detect light. It has IR blasters and receivers, so it can communicate with another one or control your television. It makes sound, it has buttons on it, a switch. It has all of that embedded right on it, and it costs $20, okay? This is my recommendation if you ever want to learn anything about C++ programming, Arduinos, microcontrollers, but even if you don't want to dive that deep, if you don't want to get into actual code where you're typing your syntax and getting everything right, I know that's intimidating. You can also program in Python, which is a little more user-friendly. You write your scripts, you drag it on over USB like a USB drive, but even simpler than that, My 9-year-old daughter had no problem at all using Make Code on this, which is a drag and drop system. You go on the web, you drag all your logic together, you enter the numbers that you want to enter, and suddenly you've got a motion detector that like lights up unicorn colors whenever it detects motion. Or you can create a game, a Simon Says game. Or you can, you know, detect what angle it's tilting at. You can even detect a heart rate. Okay, this is a great learning device. Major props to Adafruit. This is 2 years old. This is the one with the IR blaster. They just came out with one that has Bluetooth, so you can actually control the colors of the LEDs over your phone or any number of things. Great device. This, I just picked up on a whim. This is a work light that is battery powered. Seemed useful. It ended up being extremely useful. I picked it up to work on pinball machines, but it's come in handy to work behind televisions, underneath cabinets, anywhere where you would normally pull out your phone and get the flashlight on. This, super handy, has a little stand, stands up all by itself, and much, much brighter than your phone. And it can be in bright mode, slightly less bright mode, and best on Halloween, put it underneath the window, strobe light. $20, it looks like a DeWalt product, it is totally not. It's a no-name brand, but it's available on Amazon. It is waterproof, and it doubles as a USB battery pack. Got a 4,000 milliamp hour battery in there. Super handy, I love these things. You can get them in a pack of two for slightly less. Last thing, anybody that knows me knows that I'm a bit of a VR nut, and this was the year of mobile VR. The Oculus Quest, which if you read any holiday gift guide, you probably saw it on there. If you tried to buy one in the past few weeks, you probably couldn't because they're totally sold out. But this is the culmination of the past 6-7 years of consumer VR. This is a device that used to require a computer to deliver the same experience. Until this year, if you wanted to move your body around in space and have that reflected in VR, we call that 6 degrees of freedom, where you're looking and moving in any direction and tracking your hand controllers in the same amount of precision. 6 degrees of freedom, you needed a PC. It had to be cabled to your computer, you had to be running software, you had to invest in all of the video cards and infrastructure and launch your apps and make sure everything's running. Now, it's all in one. It uses 4 cameras to look out, to map the world, to see the controllers, to position the headset and everything else in space, and it just works. It's in VR all the time. You don't have to launch anything. You just put it on and you're good to go. Now, personally, I have this mounted to what's called the Vive Deluxe Audio Strap, which has these headphones. That does not ship with the unit, but I did find that to be slightly more comfortable. But out of the box, it's still magic. I mean, this is something that I didn't expect to see this early and makes VR so much easier to adopt. It is the most friction-free version of virtual reality, and I'm glad it's here. I can't wait to see the next iteration of this and where we're going. VR is at the very beginning still, it's the early days, and it continues to excite me. Thank you for watching, and from all of us here at Tested, we can't wait to see you in 2020. Have a safe and wonderful new year, and we'll see you next year.